New tech specs for Xbox Series X have been revealed. Xbox Series X will have 12 teraflops of GPU power. It will support backwards compatibility all the way back to original Xbox games. It will include hardware accelerated ray tracing, support up to 120 frames per second, and will support quick resume for multiple games simultaneously. So we should be able to quickly jump between save states in multiple games.
Yes, those are just some of the technical specs of the new console revealed by head of Xbox, Phil Spencer, in an Xbox Newswire blog post today. The post goes into detail on several key themes for Series X: power and speed, instant immersion, and game compatibility. Much of what's being discussed has been touched on previously, but this is a more definitive technical rundown of the console than in previous statements from Microsoft.
So on power and speed, Spencer points out the Series X's custom AMD processor, capable of 12 teraflops of GPU performance, which he says will result in higher frame rates in larger worlds. Alongside that, variable rate shading support will allow developers to prioritize how effects are applied to their games, resulting in, quote, more stable frame rates and higher resolution, with no impact on the final image quality. Spencer also says that hardware-accelerated DirectX ray tracing will be a first for consoles.
So on instant immersion, Spencer points to the console's solid-state hard drive replacing the traditional hard disk drives of previous Xbox consoles, which should drastically improve load times. The console will also have a quick resume feature that allows you to re-enter suspended games with almost no wait times, and not just one, several games.
Yeah.
Latency is seemingly being improved for both controllers and HDMI, including HDMI 2.1 support for you tech friends, and the console will support up to 120 frames per second, as you mentioned a moment ago. Good stuff.
And on game compatibility, Spencer promises that all Xbox One games, as well as 360 and original Xbox games already supported by Xbox One, will work on Series X and will benefit from the better hardware with no developer work required. Spencer also announced Smart Delivery, which will allow games to be bought once and work across all compatible consoles, despite being technically different versions of the same game. This will apply to all Xbox Game Studios titles, and developers can even apply it to games they release on Series X later than Xbox One. Xbox Game Pass will continue to feature first-party games at launch, and that includes Halo Infinite.
So that means I buy Cyberpunk 2077 in September, and it's gonna work just fine and get a little nice little boost on Series X.
Exactly.
That's good stuff right there. So this news seemingly confirms a past leak that said the Series X would have 12 teraflops. That same leak also said that the PS5 would reach 9.2 teraflops, though for now, that latter point remains unconfirmed. Regardless, it is a jump from existing platforms. PS4 Pro, 4.2 teraflops. Xbox One X, 6 teraflops. Google Stadia, capable of up to 10.7, but that's tempered by your internet speed and anyone's willingness to actually subscribe to it.
Yeah, it looks like we're in for a powerful new machine from Microsoft for the next generation. Meanwhile, we continue to wait for any concrete PlayStation 5 news from Sony. The company has been very quiet about its next-gen console and plans, and has recently canceled public appearances at PAX East and the Game Developers Conference. But when Sony is ready to share more info on the PS5, and as Microsoft continues to reveal more about the Xbox Series X, you'll hear all about it here at IGN.